Did you ever play King of the Mountain? Feels pretty good to be on top. What about strolling to the top of a hill on a day hike? Nice view of your town. Some of you may have even gone on camping trips and climbed to the top of a mountain. Yeah, life looks different up there. Well, now imagine getting to the top of some of the highest and tallest mountains in the world. What do you think you would find there? In these elevated regions, the weather is cold and the air is thin, making it a tough place for plants and animals to live. This is the Alpine Tundra, a biome that is home to plants and animals that thrive in this harsh climate. In this video, we'll explore the Alpine Tundra and get to know what life is like at high elevation. We've gathered some naturally wonderful things for you to explore on the Socratica Foundation website. Find more smart, fun videos and downloads, fact-filled games and activities that help you learn and remember. Find the link below. We just called the Alpine Tundra a biome, but what exactly does that mean? A biome is a place where plants and animals live together because they need similar things to survive. For example, red-eyed tree frogs live in the rainforest because rainforests have lots of water. And guess who needs lots of water to survive? Yup, red-eyed tree frogs. Biomes are found all over the world, and each one has its own special climate, plants, and animals. Some of the most well-known biomes include deserts, rainforests, and grasslands. The Alpine Tundra is a special kind of biome found high up in the mountains, above the tree line where it's too cold and windy for trees to grow. We call places like this high altitude. Altitude is the word scientists use to describe how far something is above sea level. This word comes from the Latin root altus, which means high or high up. So the Alpine Tundra is at high altitude, meaning it's very high above sea level. These high altitude Alpine Tundra biomes are found high up in the mountains all around the world, like the Rockies in North America, the Andes in South America, and the Himalayas in Asia. The climate in the Alpine Tundra is very harsh, with cold temperatures, strong winds, and very little rainfall. Summers are short and cool, while winters are long and freezing. We like to talk about the weather. How hot it is, will we need an umbrella today? But scientists like ecologists are more interested in the climate. That is, what are the conditions like on average over a long period of time? The climate of the Alpine Tundra is pretty extreme. Temperatures are usually very cold, even in the summer. During the summer months, the temperature can range from about 40 to 60 degrees Fahrenheit or 4 to 15 degrees Celsius, but it can drop below freezing at night. In the winter, it gets even colder, usually around 0 degrees Fahrenheit or negative 18 degrees Celsius, but can fall even lower. The Alpine Tundra doesn't get a lot of precipitation, and most of it comes in the form of snow. The Alpine Tundra is often called a frozen desert because it gets so little rainfall, just like deserts, but it's also very cold. Seasonal changes in the Alpine Tundra are very noticeable. In the short summer, plants and animals have to make the most of the brief warm period to grow and gather food. Winter is long and harsh, with freezing temperatures and strong winds, making it a tough time for all living things in this biome. Because of these frigid conditions, it is very difficult for plant and animal life to survive all the way up in these mountains. In the Alpine Tundra, life is all about survival. Speaking of living things, we're already planning our next series about the animals of each biome. We're committed to bringing you the best educational content for kids, but we can't do it without you. Your donations are crucial for our work to continue. Support our nonprofit and help us keep the wild in the spotlight. Donate now and make a difference. Alpine Tundra biomes are high up in the mountains, but how high are we talking about? Alpine tundras usually start around 3,500 to 4,000 meters above sea level, and continue up to the highest peaks in the world. It's not exactly a definite line up in the sky, there's a range, and that's because it depends on exposure to sun and wind. If you've ever heard someone say, "The air is thin up here," you might be thinking, "Huh? What? How can the air be thin? Air's just air, isn't it?" What they really mean is that there's less oxygen available to breathe. At sea level, there is high air pressure. All the molecules in the air, including oxygen, are squished closer together. The higher up you go, or the higher in altitude you are, there's lower air pressure. So the oxygen molecules are more spread out in the air. This means every time you take a breath, you breathe in fewer of those delicious essential oxygen molecules we all need to live. With all these harsh conditions, it's clear that we would have a hard time living in the alpine tundra biome. So how do the native flora and fauna, that's ecology speak for plants and animals, do it? First, there has to be reliable plant life as a food source before animals can call a place home. But can plants grow reliably in the alpine tundra? These conditions might make you say no. The soil in the alpine tundra is very different from what you might find in your garden at home. It's usually thin, rocky, and doesn't have many nutrients, which makes it tough for plants to grow. Despite these challenges, some plants have special qualities that allow them to grow and survive in this challenging place. For instance, while there are no tall trees with deep roots, smaller plants with shallow roots make it work. You'll find low-growing plants like lichens, mosses, and small shrubs. But what about the cold and windy weather? Doesn't that kill off all the plants? Some plants have small, thick leaves that help them conserve water and protect them from freezing temperatures. Others can photosynthesize at lower temperatures, which means they can still make food even when it's really cold. Photosynthesis is how plants make their own food. We humans have to eat, but you've probably noticed that plants don't eat to survive like we do. They use sunlight, water, and air to survive. The green part of the plant, called chlorophyll, captures sunlight. The plant then mixes sunlight with water from the ground and carbon dioxide from the air to make food, or sugar, and oxygen. The plant keeps the food to grow and releases the oxygen into the air for us to breathe. Plants in the alpine tundra are very impressive because they can still photosynthesize when it's extremely cold outside. The alpine tundra is also home to some amazing flower blooms in the springtime. Even though the growing season is very short, these hardy plants burst into vibrant colors, covering the landscape with beautiful flowers. We like to look at flowers, but it's important to realize they're actually a food source for pollinators. Animals also get creative with how to survive in this rough place. Common animals you might find here include mountain goats, pikas, and marmots. Mountain goats are excellent climbers with strong hooves that help them jump from peak to peak in this rocky land. They also have thick fur to keep them warm in the freezing temperatures. Pikas are small, rabbit-like creatures that gather and store food during the short summer so they can survive the long winter. Marmots are large ground-dwelling squirrels that hibernate during the winter. Hibernation is one of those creative survival strategies you see animals use in the alpine tundra. It's a way for them to conserve energy by sleeping through the coldest months when food is hard to find. The animals of the alpine tundra biome even have adaptations we can't see. Remember, there's not a lot of oxygen up at high altitude? That's okay, because their red blood cells are better at grabbing onto oxygen molecules. What? Make sure to subscribe to Socratica Kids, because coming soon is our series on the animals of each biome. We'll learn more about all the amazing ways animals have devised to live in the cold, windy, and low oxygen environment of the alpine tundra. The alpine tundra is a pretty remote place, and there aren't a lot of people up there. So it might surprise you that even though most human populations are far away, the way we all live can still have an effect on this special place. Human activities like burning fossil fuels and polluting the air have a big impact on the alpine tundra, and it's important to understand how we can help protect this unique biome. Climate change is one of the biggest threats, causing temperatures to rise and snow to melt faster. This makes it harder for the plants and animals that are so well adapted for cold weather to survive. But there are efforts to protect the alpine tundra. Many alpine areas are part of national parks and protected areas. National parks have rules people must follow to help preserve the natural habitat. Scientists and environmental groups are also working to raise awareness about the importance of this biome and find ways to combat climate change. Today, we learned about life at high altitude in the alpine tundra biome. Do you think you could live in the alpine tundra? What would you like the most? The epic mountain goat jumpers? Or the plants that grow fast in the summertime? If you want to learn more about other biomes, be sure to subscribe to learn about the other 10. Now it's time to watch another great video from Socratica Kids. You get to pick. And don't forget to check out our website with smart fun extras we made just for you, linked below. Did you know that these videos are made possible by our donors? The Socratica Foundation is committed to making free educational resources for kids. Donate today.